Gajewski, the Embassy of Poland and the Kosciuszko Foundation, I would like to welcome everyone to the award ceremony of the 67th Kosciuszko Foundation Chopin Piano Competition. Tonight we will award exceptionally talented young people, winners of the competition, and we will have the chance to listen to the greatest compositions of Frédéric Chopin performed by these excellent musicians. I would also like to inform you that today's concert will be played at Steinway Grand Piano, a gift of the 100 for the 100th committee, and in memory of Randall J.K. The Steinway was presented as a gift to the government of Poland to commemorate the 100th anniversary of the regaining of Poland's independence. Before we begin this wonderful musical evening, let me give the floor to our host, Ambassador Marek.
Ladies and gentlemen, excellencies, welcome.
Good evening.
It will be my and my wife's second march with Chopin's music in a row. Yesterday we had the pleasure to attend a recital performed by Brian Gantz at Strathmore Concert Hall. I was not playing. In a moving gesture, Brian dedicated Chopin's Mazurka and Polonaises to the brave people of Ukraine. He said, quote unquote, from the heart of Poland, a salute to the Ukrainian spirit. My God, isn't it a remarkable spirit? All the bravery of the nation of fearless heroes, courageously defending their freedom, but also ours. If you don't mind, I'd like you to rise. Observe a moment of silence in honor of all the victims of the Russian aggression against Ukraine against our beloved friend. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, let me extend my sincerest gratitude to our partners from the Kosciuszko Foundation and the entire team of the Chopin Piano Competition, and personally to Madam Director, Mrs. Barbara Bernhardt, and Mr. Martin Labazevitch, the Artistic Director of the competition. Many thanks also to the members of the jury, Piotr Gajewski, Piotr Paleczny, Krzysztof, Alexander Kobrin, and Akiko. And of course, my heartfelt congratulations to the laureates, whom we will know shortly. Last but not least, special kudos to Marek, the president of the Kosciuszko Foundation, who is right now on the Polish-Ukrainian border assisting refugees. Dear friends, on a final note, let me go back for a while to the Ukrainian spirit. As you probably know, for us, the Poles, nobody beats Chopin in terms of cultural influence in the musical world. And nobody beats our greatest poet, Adam Mickiewicz, in literature. He once wrote a sonnet which superbly encapsulates Ukraine's spirit and its enchanting beauty. The Akerman step. Into the wide expanse I plunge, waterless ocean. Deep in the grass the wagon dips, rolls like a boat, amid the bending waves, flowers are seen to float, avoiding coral islands, weeds, in winding motion, darkening in the west, no hill, no path will appear. I stare into the sky, at every guiding star, is that the rising dawn, a shining cloud afar, the Dniester, Akerman country lighthouse, it is near. Stop. Ah, so quiet. Listen. Hear the calling cranes. Fleeing the hawk, they seek invisibility. Butterflies moving wings in grass up on the plains. A snake, slippery breasted, bends the greenery. In such a quiet, I, excited, take some pains to hear my Lithuanian's call. Let's go. No home for me. Stój, jak cicho. Słyszę cmoknące żurawie, które gdy nie dościgły źrenice sokowe. Słyszę kędy się młoty, który sam trawie, kędy wąż ciską piersią dotyka się zioła. W takiej ciszy, tak ucho natężam ciekawie, że słyszałbym głos z Litwy. Jedźmy. Dziękuję. Thank you very much.
Started online, continued live, very meaningful, especially right now in the time of global pandemic, travel restrictions, all this political unrest and upheavals. So when the contestants at the beginning of the competition were asked to describe the music of Frédéric Chopin with one word, they listed lots of beautiful adjectives, romantic, intimate, patriotic, elegant. And I would like to add two more that describe my experience during the competition. It was uniting and healing. And I felt like during this time, it was especially appealing and important. So it was a really beautiful, beautiful journey. The competition has a long history. It started in 1949, but I'm proud and happy to announce that the first step is happening in Washington, D.C. We have a wonderful team with Martin Labazevitch as an artistic director, Jason Solinas as competition director, Yola Stefanska as an advancement director, as well as Routine Classical, who is helping with technical aspects of the competition. And we did it. We did it. It was kind of a, till now, the competition was happening in New York. It was supposed to be an experiment. I feel like it's a success. And hopefully, the competition will be happening in DC from now on every 2 years. We had an amazing panel of jury. I really express my gratitude one more time. Thank you for accepting our invitation, being with us, shifting the competition to yet another level. It's truly honored to work with you, all of you. The fact that the first time during the Chopin, the Kosciuszko Foundation Chopin Piano Competition, we had orchestra involved, and our three finalists played with the members of National Philharmonic under the baton of Maestro Gajewski, was a new addition, very attractive, and added another level. And one more to the whole event. I'd like to thank Maestro Gajewski for helping with all this. So we actually succeeded having the orchestra with us this time. We're going to our contestants, all of them played beautiful. I congratulate all of you. It was an amazing treat yesterday. For almost 7 hours we had this musical treat of musical Chopin and Szymanowski. We're going to listen to you playing again today, short pieces. Martin's going to announce them in a moment. And going back to Ukraine for a second, the Kosciuszko Foundation stands in solidarity with Ukraine, and we have established a special fund which you can access on our website, which is www.kyiv.org. And the money will go directly to those people, those families, young mothers and children who go to Poland and seek refuge in Poland. Also, the proceeds of the Kosciuszko Foundation fundraising ball that will happen late April all the proceeds are going to be donated to Ukrainians in need. So thank you again for hosting us here. I would ask Martin right now to introduce the contestants and tell us more about the music we're going to hear tonight. Thank you.
Thank you, Martin. Thank you, Mr. Ambassador, for having us here tonight. You've mentioned everything I wanted to say, but there's one more thing I wanted to thank. One group of people that has been with us from the very beginning. We started doing Chopin events 4 years ago, and every year they are becoming stronger, better, and this year we brought them to the level we could only dream of. And I'd like to thank those three people sitting there, Basia Bernhardt, Jason Salunas, and Jana Stefańska, for responding to my crazy ideas and being always with us. And this is absolutely a dream team that works perfectly. We've had incredible response to this competition. We had people from all over the world applying. We chose 12 contestants that came that participated. In the virtual portion of the competition, we had people from Latin America, we had people from United States, Asia, from Poland, from Europe, and the jury selected six contestants who came to Washington D.C. for the first time in the history of the competition. And for the past 3 days, we just had a holiday and party of Chopin music. Today especially, on the wake of this horrendous thing happening right now in Europe, I was listening to those three performances of the concertos, written exactly around 1830, exactly around the time of the November uprising. And I just couldn't held back my tears, thinking of what Chopin was thinking, how was he reacting to the occupant, to the Russian occupant. So history, of course, repeats itself. And I remember reading words of a Russian general who was in charge of the Russian army at the time, who said, "There may be Poles, but there will be no Poland." How was he wrong? And I believe that this time it will be the same. Now I'm going to introduce six contestants who will play a short version of their program for us tonight. And before I introduce them, I remember this quote of one of the greatest musicians of the 20th century, Leonard Bernstein, who said, "This is our response to violence, to play music more intensely, more devotedly, more beautifully than ever before."
Thank you.
invite the jury chair, Mr. Maestro Piotr Gajewski, to announce the winners of the 67th Kosciuszko Foundation competition. We would like to ask the jury to come to the stage as well. Piotr Paleczny.
Thank you.